In the previous lecture, we learned how to assess the lease term on the commencement date. Sometimes after the commencement date, significant events or changes in circumstances might occur during the lease term that can affect the length of lease term that was previously assessed on the commencement date. In this case, the lessee should reassess the length of the lease term. That reassessment is done only if those events or changes in circumstances are within the control of the lessee, and can affect whether the lessee is reasonably certain to exercise an option not previously included in its determination of the lease term, or not to exercise an option previously included in its determination of the lease term. Examples of significant events or changes in circumstances that might occur after the commencement date might include: significant leasehold improvements. After the commencement date, the lessee might discover for some reasons that it needs to undertake some leasehold improvements to the underlying asset. It is expected that these improvements will have a significant economic benefit for the lessee. These improvements were not anticipated on the commencement date, when the lessee was first assessing the lease term. If the lessee knew about it on the commencement date, the length of the lease term would have been assessed differently. Another example is a significant modification to or customization of the underlying asset that was not anticipated on the commencement date. This modification is expected to generate significant economic benefits for the lessee, or might make the asset so specialized that a replacement might not be found easily. Had the lessee knew about that modification from the beginning, he would have considered an option to extend the lease term that was not considered when assessing the lease term on the commencement date. Also, the lessee might sublease the underlying asset to a third party for a period that extends after the end of the term of the original lease. If the sublease transaction was on the radar on the commencement date, the lessee would have considered an option to extend the lease term that was not considered when assessing the lease term on the commencement date. Also, a business decision that should be taken during the lease term, and that was not anticipated on the commencement date, like for example, a decision to extend the lease of a complementary asset, or to dispose of an alternative asset, or to dispose of a business unit within which the underlying asset is used. If it was known from the beginning about that decision, the lessee would have considered an option to extend or terminate the lease that was not considered when assessing the lease term on the commencement date. Let us illustrate with an example. A construction company, the lessee, signed a 3-year contract on the 1st of January 2XX to lease some heavy equipment from equipment company, the lessor, to use in its construction projects of residential buildings located at the outskirts of the city. The lease agreement is for 150,000 currency that is payable over equal annual installments of 50,000 currency. Both the lessee and the lessor cannot terminate the lease during the first 2 years. Only the lessee can terminate the contract after the first 2 years. Effective January 2XX, the government has announced several incentives to boost the construction of residential buildings in the outskirts of the city. As a result, construction company expects a significant increase in the volume of real estate development over the next 5 years in that area, and that it will have a chance to sign one or more new construction contracts. Also, construction company anticipates an increase in the market prices for leasing heavy construction equipment over the same period. What is the lease term for this agreement? The lease is enforceable during the first 2 years, which is the non-cancellable period of the lease, as neither party can terminate during these first 2 years. In addition, there is a reasonable certainty that the lessee will not exercise the option to terminate the lease. This is due to the expected increase in the real estate development business, and the expected increase in the market prices of heavy equipment. And since the lessor cannot force the lessee to terminate the lease remains enforceable for the third year as well. Therefore, the lease term is the whole 3 years of the contract. Let us continue with our example. After 1 year from the commencement date, a newly released high-tech heavy equipment was available in the market. Based on the analysis of construction company, it was determined that this new released equipment will provide it with a competitive advantage over its rivals in the market in terms of project completion times, and this will increase its chances of getting more contracts to be signed within the next few years. Based on these facts, construction company decided to invest in this newly released equipment. Figure out whether there is a need to revise the previously determined lease term of this agreement. Here, the company decided to invest in the newly introduced high-tech equipment, and that is a significant business decision that is within the control of the lessee, which means it is up to the lessee to choose whether to invest in that new equipment or not. Also, that business decision affects whether there is a reasonable certainty that the lessee will exercise or not exercise the lease termination option in the contract. The fact that the company decided to invest in that newly introduced equipment creates an economic incentive for the lessee to terminate the current contract for leasing the outdated equipment. So, it is reasonably certain that the lessee will exercise the lease termination option in the contract, and therefore, the lease term should be revised to be 2 years, instead of the previously determined 3 years. Of course, this reassessment of the lease term will have its impact on the accounting for the lease contract, as we shall see later in this course.